guys, welcome to my video. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make these super cute, adorable, awesome jars. I think they're super cute. You can use them as decoration like I am, as decorative jars, or makeup brush holders, or any kind of item of your choice kind of holder. I'm using flowers because I am using them as decoration, and I went with the gold and turquoise color scheme with this white and gold ribbon. You can personalize it to your own style, but the steps to make them are super, super, super simple, really easy, and it was really cheap as well. So if you are interested in making your own little jars, then keep watching. I think that they give the perfect little touch to your to any room. Or to your vanity if you're using them as makeup brush holders or as decoration. And I really hope you enjoy this video, so let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we need is metallic gold spray paint. This is by Krylon, and I got it from Michael's for 10 bucks. We're gonna need Mod Podge in its glossy form, and this was $1 at Target. We're going to need glitter. This is by Martha Stewart in yellow gold, but you're more than welcome to use any other form of glitter. A spongy brush or foam brush, and of course your jar. I really thought this jar was super cute because it has a nice design in the front, and it was only $1 at Target, so it was definitely a steal. I recommend latex gloves because we are working with a spray paint and you don't want to get your hands all nasty and grimy, so especially if you have a fresh manicure you don't want to ruin. And if you're working on a surface you don't want to damage, I would use saran wrap or just anything that will really cover it. So time to get down and dirty. We're gonna remove the lid from the jar and just place that upside down and give your spray paint bottle a good shake and spray away. And make sure you spray the jar 12 inches away as well. Now we're just gonna wait 30 minutes for the spray paint to completely dry. And now we just wait. Here's my kitty. You can read some books. I definitely recommend these two. They're super great reads. Or you can just surf the web, go on Pinterest, anything that will kill some time. So timer is done and it's time for the second coat. We're just going to repeat the same process. Spray paint it 12 inches away, because you don't want the spray paint to come out all blotchy in certain areas. So just make sure you're spraying it evenly and just standing 12 inches away. So once you've waited 30 minutes for your second coat to dry up, we are now going to get started on the fun part, which is applying the glitter. And we're going to use Mod Podge for that, of course. And I'm going to be applying it on the bottom third of the jar. You can apply it anywhere you want, but it looks best, in my opinion, on the bottom. We're going to be using our spongy brush or our foam brush to apply the Mod Podge. We're going to actually put on our gloves because it's going to get real messy real soon, so make sure you wear your gloves. We're gonna turn our jar, and if you want to really get that straight line, I recommend paper or saran wrap to make that line on your jar. And I'm just placing it carefully. So now that I have that, I'm gonna start applying the Mod Podge onto the jar. So now we sprinkle our glitter onto the Mod Podge we applied to the jar. And just make sure you apply the Mod Podge per section and not just all at once on the jar, because you don't want the Mod Podge to dry up and then our glitter wouldn't be able to stick onto it properly. So make sure you're doing it by section. And this is our final look. It's okay if there's a little bit of Mod Podge on the edges, it'll dry up. And now on to our next jar. We're gonna need chalkboard paint. I got this from Michaels. This Americana acrylic paint in sea glass. You can choose any color. Your foam brush and your jar. We're going to be painting the jar with the chalkboard paint. And we're going to be painting it vertically and horizontally. So just make sure you give your chalkboard paint a good shake and start painting it. The chalkboard paint doesn't have to totally cover the jar. It's just acting as a base for the actual paint that we'll be using. So it's okay if there's some streaks where you can see through it. And it does get really messy, so I definitely recommend some gloves for this. And just let it dry for an hour. Once it's totally dry, you can go ahead and start painting it with the color of your choice. And once again, I'm using sea glass. And I got that from Michaels as well. So yeah, just paint, paint, paint away. Make sure you let the paint dry for an hour between coats. I did 2 coats of paint for my jar. And this is the final masterpiece. Thanks for watching, and I really hope you enjoyed this video.